So today it's the day to talk about studio stands and tripods. I use in my studio very often this one. It's pretty easy to use. You can get it up and down and you can collapse it like that and can extend it like that. But with a camera on, it's sometimes really exhausting to do that all by yourself. And then I have another tripod. That's a little bit bigger. This is this one. I use it for my bigger camera. You can also get that up and can move everything, but you can imagine to move it from one place to the next one, it's also not the easiest thing to do. Even this Berlebach tripod is really nice, but to make quick adjustments, it's not the right tool. And now we come to my story of the day. By accident, I found a studio stand on an online platform and it looked really impressive. And I bought it, but I couldn't pick it up because it was the pandemic and we couldn't move, couldn't drive anywhere. So I just paid it and asked the owner if I can pick it up later, and he agreed. And so 2 months later, when I was allowed to drive because I had business stuff to do in this town, I went there and we wear masks and blah, blah, all this stuff. And I picked it up. I had to borrow a car from a friend because it's so heavy and big. And it was a very long drive there. So I think it was like 300 kilometers or 400 kilometers, something like that. It was snowing and it was, anyway. And the owner already told me that's pretty heavy, so it should be like 150 kilos. So I needed another friend to help me at home get the tripod or the studio stand out of the car, down into my studio. And then we assembled it together because I think I couldn't assemble a 150 kilo tripod all by myself. And then I did some renovation, I did some cleaning. Yeah, I did even paint it, so it's still a little bit wet, but not so much. I painted it like last night, but now it looks really good. And I think now it's time to show you my new toy, what I really love. So give me a second, I'll get it here. Ta-da! I got it. It's really cool. I can even move this camera with one hand up and down. Look at that, how easy it is. I have to go back here. I can put it up also. I need a second hand for putting it up, but easy to move. And I can move it in all directions. Like this. So I go out here. I can make these movements here very easy, and I can even make boink, sorry about that, and I can even make this kind of move so it's still straight. And what is really cool, I can move it very down to the bottom, and I think it's really nice and easy to work with. So look at this tray here. This tray by itself has 3.5 kilos. It's super heavy, but it's also super steady, and I have all my tools directly in my camera. So the manufacturer of this tripod is Kenbo. They still make tripods like that. Mine is like 70 years old, and the new ones are called UST and UBS. They are also heavy duty like that one. Kenbo also makes large format cameras. I wrote them because I thought it's gonna be necessary to do some maintenance on the tripod because it's 70 years old. And yeah, they answered me really quick, like, I'm not lying, like in 10 minutes or something, and said, no, as long as everything is working, I don't have to do anything. Do you have anything at home that's 70 years old that just works and you don't have to do anything? I think it's really cool and it's gonna make my work much easier. If I use the small camera on this tripod, I really can do everything with one hand. So what can I say? I'm super happy. It's super nice. And in the upcoming videos, you will see me working with this guy here all the time. And I can go down to the bottom. I can make finally shots from the ceiling. It's perfect. And this tripod still fits in my studio because normally these tripods are very, very high. Like they are like 3 meters or 2.50 meters. So Shane Barkovich working with a similar one, and his is much bigger than this one. So I got super lucky to have this tool now in my studio, and I hope you enjoyed this short episode. It was really fun to make this thing beautiful again and to pick it up. I'm pretty excited, and there's more stuff coming very soon with a new lens, just saying. And yeah, thanks for watching, subscribe, and I'll be back, guys.